Today I'm going to discuss two systematic reviews on potty training. The first systematic review is on the association of the start of potty training with the development of lower urinary tract dysfunctions. And the second systematic review is on elimination signals, which are signals which the child gives when it needs to go to the toilet. Well, welcome back to Pelvic News Channel, the channel for all physiotherapists with an interest in the pelvic region. If you like this channel, hit the notification bell down below or subscribe to my channel. And of course, it would be really nice to inform your colleagues as well about this channel. Years ago, long before I had children of my own, I noticed quite a difference in potty training between my Austrian and my Dutch friend. The strategy of my Austrian friend was to let her son play along in the field when he was a year and a half without a nappy. And of course, look at the signals and put him on the potty when needed. He was potty trained before the age of two. My Dutch friend, she had a completely different strategy, and her strategy was to wait until the child gave the signal, I want to go to the toilet. So to wait until she thought he was ready to go to the toilet, and he was toilet trained before the age of four. As a pelvic physiotherapist, I don't treat children myself, so this is not my specific area of interest, but I think it's really interesting topic for all physiotherapists treating patients and who are treating pediatric patients as well, or just to have the knowledge as a mother or aunt or whatever. So that's the reason why I chose these two systematic reviews today. With the two systematic reviews of today, you can make evidence-based decisions regarding providing information for patients or the caregivers of the patients regarding potty training. The first systematic review was on the development of low urinary tract dysfunctions and the age when potty training was started. And what they found was that if the potty training was started before 24 months, the children were less likely, 23% less likely to develop low urinary tract symptoms. And in a subgroup analysis, they found that 23% of the children were less likely to develop daytime urine loss and even 37% less nighttime bedwetting. The second systematic review looked at elimination signals a child between 0 and 4, which is non-toilet trained, gives as a signal to void. And they divided into two types of elimination signals, the ones who are tactile, visual or audible, and the clinically accessible signals like heart rate. They found that 30 to 50% of the children wake up before they need to void. And the most frequently used signals are a change in facial look, and it frequently is accompanied with a movement of the body like kicking, pushing, pointing, waving or stepping motions. And children stop playing, that was about at the age of one, even a short cry or vocalizations, and other arousal signs like opening of the eyes, movement of the body and crying. And clinically assessed signals were a rising heart rate and at the same time a decrease in the breathing frequency. Older children give more elimination signals. And if caregivers are more aware of these elimination signals, potty training can be started sooner and the children can become potty trained quicker and maybe prevent lower urinary tract dysfunctions in the future. Both these systematic reviews have limitations, like the use of different terminology, the design of the studies, which is often observational, or just the small numbers in the studies. So there's definitely room for improvement. But with the knowledge of these systematic reviews, I think that the healthcare professionals like us can give evidence-based advice to caregivers and help them even better. So I hope you like this video and continue watching my channel. Consider subscribing down below and hit the notification bell. And well, I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.